I'd hardly taken a step forward when I heard the door close behind me. When I turned around, the door wasn't there anymore. And all that was left of it was a strange shadow on the wall. I searched. I despaired. And I screamed until my throat began to burn. The candles started to run out, as did the batteries in my torch. From within the most suffocating darkness, the hours went by until turning into days, and I began to fall in and out of a restless sleep. I would hear voices, sometimes right next to me, other times a few yards away. It seemed like they were coming from the other side of the wall. Desperate cries, howling in horror, and sometimes, the worst of all, a vast, oppressive silence would fall, seeming to emanate from everywhere and nowhere all at once. There was nobody there, just hallucinations, nightmares, black nothingness, and the song from that music box. Trapped in this impossible place, I wondered if I was going to die there.
Etienne, do you have any news on Daniel yet?
Oh, Sophie. No. We've been calling him at home all day, but there's no response. Do you know if he's got a mobile phone?
No, I don't think so. And if he does, he doesn't tend to keep it on him.
Oh, man. I think I should pass by the Husher place when I leave, just to see if they know anything.
Husher the writer? Your client?
Yeah. I sent Daniel over there on Friday, and I haven't heard from him since.
What's the address? I'm going to stop by Daniel's place, and if I don't find him, I can go around and ask about him.
The house on the outskirts of town, on Highway EB-15. Number 4, Abbott Thomas Road. It's a big house.
Okay. I'm headed over. Call me if you find him.
Of course. Same to you.
Thank you.
The door was open.
Is there anybody home?
I should take a look on this floor first. Huh. Nope. Mm-mm.
Thank you. Thank you.
was that?
Thank you.